Hallelujah. I want to give you first read and the scripture, which is so good. Hebrew 12, chapter 1 through the 2. This good crowd of witnesses. Crowd of witness, okay, would you open the Bible if you would? Therefore, since we are surrounded by the such a great crowd of witness, great crowd of witness, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangled us. And let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us. I'm going to stop here. These scriptures talking to us, crowd of witness who going to give encouragement and strength to you. The good crowd of witness, crowd of the witness is, let me tell you, is composed of the people, described in the Hebrew chapter 11, we call the chapter of faith. You know what I'm talking about. Their forefather is constant endurance. Constant encouragement to us. We do not struggle alone. We do not struggle alone. They had been struggling. You can see Hebrews chapter 11. A lot of the person who strong had a strong faith of God. We are not forced to struggle with the problem we have. Other peoples who are showing the Hebrews chapter 11, like Abel, Enoch, Noah, Abraham, and Isaac, Jacob, Joseph, and Moses, Rahab, you know. Their witness stirs us, make us, and give us strength, power to hold to walking in Jesus. Oh, my God. Today's scripture, Hebrews chapter 12, compares Christian to athlete who run in the racing stadium. The highlight of Olympic Games is the marathon. marathon race, in which the runner must face the running 26 quarter miles. The runner enter the stadium. He look at the round. All people were standing and cheering to the runner. And then he reached the finish line at last. At that moment, all the audience who cheered in the stadium in the stand up cried out the victory, victory. Huh? Oh, my Lord. Oh, I like that. I like that. Marathon. Learning. I love jogging. Not marathon. Our life is like a marathon. We must finish. We must finish the course of the race of our life like a marathon runner. Then we stand before the Lord in the end. We will be prayed by the Lord God. Our Father is going saying that, well done, my faithful servant. Oh, you are good and faithful servant. I love you. Hebrews 12 chapter 1 says, therefore, since we are surrounded by the such a great crowd of witness. In all sporting events, the cheer of the audience cannot be overlooked. Cheers by audience that comes from fan and friend, family, give the prayer great strength, encouragement. Hear me, my friend. In this manner, our forefathers of faith, showing in Hebrews chapter 11, who ran before us, cheering and encouraging us, talking to you. What they had done by the grace of the God as our example that we should lesson from them. Hallelujah. Oh, my Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hebrews 11 chapter 2 say this faith is what the ancient were commended for. I want to tell you Abraham, we called father of the faith. Abraham supporting us. What he has done. Abraham today in heaven, and he is standing at the balcony of the heaven and looking down to you. My brother and sister, God called me to leave my father's house when I was 75 years old. So I left my father everything I used to do. I obeyed God's command. God bless me greatly. So take courage. You can do it like me. Abraham talking to you in heaven. Noah talking to you too in heaven. Noah built a huge ark with nothing but faith. But faith, hallelujah, oh my, thank you, Lord. But faith, Noah would encourage us today. Whenever we read the story of Noah, he going to say to you, be patient, even if really hard, don't worry about. No matter what you are doing, look at me. I had built an ark of ship. Large ark. God ordered me. I obeyed. So, my people were saved when earth was destroyed by the rain. Secondly, I want to tell you, we have to lesson from this scripture as of today's text. Hebrews 12:1 says, let us throw up everything that hinder you, block you, and the sin that entangled you. Think about that. You know, when an athlete learns in the face, they take off the all, you know, clothes, but pants, and they throw our feet as simple as possible as they can do, so they can learn easily, make it light. No one would do wear heavy outfit, carry the heavy load, because it would slow them down. Same thing, the race of the face we have a doing now until we go to heaven. To learn will in our face of the face, we must throw off all heavy things that hinder us and the sin that so easily entangles us. And blocked us the way we should go. God ordered as your assignment. What? Oh, God. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, help me. Holy Spirit, help me. I want to open my mouth. Give me your good word to the people who are listening, understanding the good and easy. My summer. Oh, what are the heavy things that hinder our race of the faith? They are the thing. There are a lot of things to hinder us, you know. But I want to tell you, the main thing that block our relationship with God. They are the thing that we hold on to aside from God. Aside from God. You know what I'm talking about. Aside from God. Therefore, we must take up the everything that is not pleasing to the Lord whom you serve. If there is something wrong in our relationship with the Lord, we will have a problem and a difficulty in our lives. In the end, we'll go, you know, where we are going. We'll stand in the God's judgment. Oh, secondly, also same scripture say, let us, let me, okay, so before I go to the third the subject, I'm going to tell you some example. What problem that tangled us and blocked us the way we must go. In the Bible, gave us a lot of example. I'm going to pick up some the story. The first three. In Genesis, the story of Lot, and his family escaped when Sodom and Gomorrah were destroyed. Angel warned, don't get back. Stop anywhere in the plains. However, Lord's wife looked back. Eh? After getting out the cities. So she could not forget about her possession, friends, everything she liked. She became the pillar of salt. I'm going to give you another example. In Bible, we see a man named Dema. He was once worked with Paul. He was enthusiastic. He worked the mission with Paul. Bible say, 2 Timothy 4, chapter 10, for them because he loved the world so much. He deserted, gave up his mission. He left the Paul. I want to give to another the person I want to tell you in the who fell down the way his name is Judas Iscariot, who betrayed Jesus Christ. He was one of 12 disciples. He sold Jesus of 30 silver coins. He had remorse. He hanged the tree, suicide. I want to tell you, listen, my friend. We, as a Christian, we often possess sins that easily entangles us. We have to be careful, these sins. We sometimes sin out of habit, we used to do. Habit. I don't know many, each people had a habit they like. They are doing. Or due to our short tempers. We must throw up. They are all garbage and trash. We don't need such a sin. Colossians 3, chapter 3, 8 says, listen, I want to read this word of God we should keep to remember. But Now, this time, not the apostle time, not old statement time, you must rid yourself of all such a sin as Jesus. Listen, anger, rage, malice, slander, and filthy language, dirty language, from your lip. Do not lie each other. Devil is a liar. Since you have taken off your old self with its practice. It's so good, to helpful to living as the standard of our living in this earth. Yes. Keep this word. What Paul said. All right. Thirdly, Same scripture says, let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us. Runner must be patient. Running the full marathon, course 26 quarter miles in 2 hours, you know, few minutes, is a hard task. Long distance runner is very hard work. You will feel as if you a heart is about to burst, and you will have rapid pulse going up quickly. Human body function reaches a breaking point. Yes, a marathon game is very hard. I know. This learning marathon is the most the hard game in athletic. No matter how hard, I want to say, no matter how hard the race is, we must finish. You know, if you give up, runner give up while he is running in marathon, or sit down in the ground midway, even he had reached in the finish line, he will be disqualified. We must finish the race in order to achieve our goal in the race. Race of the faith. Race of faith. Race of the faith. Keep in mind, we are doing now. Like an athlete who doing marathon, Olympic game, or whatever. If we keep during the race, go back, we are defeated by Satan. Lord will give a crown to you, to those who finish the race with endurance in this race of the faith. Oh, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. My God, your God, prepared to give your reward, great reward, crown of righteousness, because you are faithful servant, you will hear this word. I want to tell you the scripture before closing. Listen, my
brother and sister. Timothy 4, chapter 7, 8. I have fight, the good fight. Good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. This Paul said. Now, there is a store for me, for you, for all Christians. The crown of righteousness, crown of righteousness, which is the Lord who the righteous judge will award me on the that day, on that day. Not only to me, but also to all who have longed for the appearing Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. Yes, the reward is waiting for you. Thank you, Lord. Bye-bye. Hallelujah. Amen.